So viewers, how are you? Praise the Lord. Today we are coming to you live from the outskirts of Dakaine Dam. We are delighted that you are tuned in from the YouTube channel. We are so much delighted to bring to you the gospel of Christ again. And let me pray for you as we begin. Precious Father, King of all the glory, we want to thank you, we want to worship you because of giving us an opportunity to hear your word today. Thank you for my viewers, oh God. May you give them the power and the understanding of your word, oh God. Give them a revelation this time that they may be able, oh God, to comprehend of your love in the mighty name of Jesus. Open our ears to hear you. Open our eyes to see you. And I pray, oh God, that this word will bring a transformation to each and every viewer today in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. So today, I would like us to think about water. And there's a scripture that is written in the book of 2 Kings, chapter number 2, where Elisha was performing some miracles. And verse 19 says, "Then the men of the city said to Elisha, 'Please notice that the situation of this city is pleasant, as my Lord sees, but the water is bad and the ground is barren.'" And this is what I'm thinking about as we look at this dam today. A lot of water is here. And I'm thinking about what these men are saying. It is pleasant. Even this place, as we look at it, it may seem so pleasant. But in saying that the water is bad, and as we are looking at this water, I want to imagine how many people could maybe be poisoned if all this water was poisoned. How many people could be poisoned by the same water? They could be millions and millions of people, because this is the same dam that feeds the whole of Nairobi and supplies water to the whole of Nairobi. And therefore, today we are thinking, if this water was poisonous, what could have happened to all those millions of people? And therefore today, this is what the men went and told Elisha. Notice the situation is so pleasant. Even the area around here, it is so pleasant with tea leaves, with flowers, with all these things. But it is saying, but notice the water is bad. And when the animals take it, it becomes barren. And therefore today we want to encourage all of us today that it is true. It could be you look pleasant from the outside, but maybe inwards from your belly, the water that is coming out of it is poisonous, because the Bible says it is out of the heart that there shall flow waters, living waters. And as we are listening to that song in the background, it is talking about living water. And Jesus, when he was talking to a woman in the well at Samaria, he told her that this water that you're drinking, you become thirsty again. But the water that I give, it is the living water. So he said, if you drink this, you never become thirsty again. And this is what we are doing today. We are coming to you to remind you that Jesus is the living water. He said, if anyone is thirsty, let them come to me and drink. Because if they drink, out of them shall flow rivers of living waters. And therefore today, even as we come to you live from this ground, let you be reminded that Jesus is the living water. And if you take of him, you never become thirsty again, because he is the living water. He is the water that we need, all of us we need, to quench the thirst and to quench every other thing that comes to us. Therefore, I want to ask you, it may be today you have never received this living water who is Jesus. It is a great opportunity so that you may believe. He said, if anyone is thirsty, let them come to me. Isaiah says, Isaiah 55, that come without money and buy for yourself bread, buy for yourself water without money. And Jesus is the living water. And today, if your situation is bad, and if it is barren, like they came and told Elijah here, that now notice that the situation is bad and the water is barren. Maybe the water in your life is barren. You are drinking out of a barren a source. Today God is coming. When they came, Elisha told them, bring me a bowl and put salt in it. And when he went, he said, this water is healed from the source. Today, you need to be healed from the source. If this water from here, the source is poisonous, everybody will get the poison wherever they are getting it from. But if this water is healed and healed from the source, you are going to realize that everybody is taking the fresh water, they are enjoying it, doing all the various activities with it, because it is a great help to everyone. And therefore, that is what Jesus will come and do in your life. He'll become the source of every other thing in you, and it will become the waters of living water. They will gush out, and you are going to become the person who God desired to be, and you'll be spreading this love of Christ, because it will be coming inside of you. It will be the light source. It will be Jesus, the liver of the living water. So are you not born again? I'm giving you this opportunity to become born again from wherever you are, so that Jesus can come in your life, and so that you can know that He wants to be the living water in you, so that you can also give the other people every other thing that is found in Jesus, so that the situation will be pleasant, and also the water will not be barren, but it will be healed from the source. When Elisha put that salt, the water was healed from the source. He will heal you from the source. Therefore, if you have never given your life to Christ, as we end this broadcast for today, just repeat this prayer after me, and Jesus will heal you from the source. Just say, Lord Jesus, thank you that you're the living waters. I need you today. I accept you today as my Lord and as my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. May God bless you, and may God do you good. Thank you for tuning in today. Remember to subscribe to our channel, and remember that Jesus is the living waters, and the waters that Jesus gives will never become dusty again, because it is healed from the source. May God bless you, and may God do you good. In Jesus' name, amen, and amen, and amen, amen. That is so good.